Steve Dotto here, and this is Ask Dotto Tech, Episode 2. Last week, I asked you if you like this format. I posted the first Ask Dotto Tech video, said, do you like it? Comment below if you do. And, well, we're about 5 days into it, and there's 3,200 of you that have watched it, and 180 comments, which is an overwhelming number of comments, all positive, saying you love this format, you want more Ask Dotto Tech. So you asked, I'm listening. Here is episode 2 of Ask Dotto Tech. Today, we're going to take a look at previewing email in Gmail. We're going to talk about how I create my screencasts. We're going to talk about using Google Photos and backing up your photos and encrypting your valuable data on removable drives and hard drives. That's all today on Ask Dotto Tech. In YouTube, Kay Norton asked, she said, love your videos, recently joined Patreon. Thank you so much, Kay. Appreciate you supporting us on Patreon. At the moment, I'm trying to figure out how to click on Gmail links without being taken to a new tab and having to wait for the page to load. I'd like to open it all at once and view the process so later I can focus on doing my initial inbox triage. Well, there's two ways that you can go about this, okay? I mean, the first way and probably the easiest way for you to open multiple emails and then go through them is you are going to have to open them all in tabs. But if you hold down the option key as you click, it will open each of them in a brand new tab as you do that. So you can just go through and open each of the emails that you have. And as you can see, what they've done is they've now opened all into new tabs for us. So that you can just then go through and you could deal with them. That might be the easiest way for you to deal with working in the system that you've built. However, there might be another way that you can do the initial triage more effectively. Now, when we use Gmail in the browser like this, it basically gives us a view where we can see the email, who it's from, the title, and then the first few words of the email. In other email applications, we have something called a preview pane where we can see more of the email and actually even sometimes edit the email in a preview pane. Outlook, for example, is famous for that. We don't have that built into Gmail right out of the box. Having said that, if you go under the gear menu and you're in your browser and you go into the settings, there you have access to the Google Labs, which is here under this kind of the main menu headings here. If I click on Labs, what these are extensions for Gmail that will give us some additional functionality. Now, the one that you want to look for is you want to go in here and you want to scroll down until you find Preview Pane and enable that. If you enable that, what will happen is your inbox will relaunch. I'm going to enable. Oh, you have to remember to go save at the bottom. That's the thing I always forget. Save changes at the bottom. And when you click back out into the inbox and refresh the browser, you will get this new tool here in your browser, which will allow you to either switch to a split view this way. So now we can see the email in here and you can actually click to reply. So this creates a preview pane which allows you to view all of the email. If you decide that you don't like this side-by-side split, you can choose a vertical split. Oh, sorry, it is a vertical split. Horizontal split. That's the one that I'm looking for, in which case the preview is in the bottom. But this might work better than opening multiple tabs as far as doing your initial email triage. Kay, I hope that helped. Thanks so much for the question. And without a doubt, one of the most popular questions on the channel is, how do you create your screencasts? People constantly ask me what camera I'm using, what microphone I'm using, and how do I create these screencasts with me in the front and the computer behind, and that sort of stuff. Well, if I tell you, I won't be special anymore, so I'm really torn. What the heck? I actually have created a couple of videos that walk through the entire process, and we will link to them down below in the show notes. There's two videos that I created just a few months ago. One is called How to Create a Screencast, the Basics. It's a little bit longer. I think it's about 17 minutes. Yeah, it's 17 and a half minutes long, and I walk through the entire screencasting process there. Great place to start. Another good place is Screencasting, How I Create My Videos, which I created a few months earlier than that, or a month earlier than that, and it also walks through the basic production process. But even better, if you want the full meal deal, if you want to know everything that I know about screencasting, I created a webinar which is available as a replay to you. Just go to the click on the YouTube card here and go and register to see my screencasting secrets. If once you enter that and register, you will be brought to a 1-hour webinar where I walk through chapter and verse exactly what happens in the creation of one of my screencasts. I go through the tools, I go through the software, and I even show you the process that I do as far as producing each of these videos. So that is the best place to learn how I do my screencasting. Click on the YouTube card and you can gain access to screencasting secrets. Regardless of which of those different resources you choose to take a look at, all of them will walk through the entire process that I use for creating these screencasts. And for all of you who have asked, thanks so much for that question. As I mentioned, we have had tremendous response to the very first Ask Dotto Tech. I asked you to comment whether or not you like the idea, and we've had a couple hundred now replies saying, it's a good idea. Ask Dotto Tech. Feed me more. Thank you. Enjoy the new format. More, please. That's what we're doing right now. Some of you also, while encouraging me to do it, have also asked me a few questions. For example, Wendy's asking, could I please address the best way to encrypt and password protect USB sticks, flash drives, my laptop? There's lots of people offering free software to download onto my computer, but can I trust them? Maybe not. You don't have to worry about trusting all of these different tools. Built into your operating system in both Windows and Mac is the ability to encrypt your drive. Now, I'm going to add this article that I found here, which is from How To Geek. It's a great article that goes through all of the different settings in both Windows and Mac. Now, in the Windows world, BitLocker encryption is built in, and they walk you through chapter and verse here how to use BitLocker in order to protect your system. They also include a description here in Linux. And on the Mac OS X or OS X, we also have the ability to do built-in encryption. And let me show you how easy it is to access that. And it's pretty much standard now and across all operating systems. I've just brought up here in Finder my different drives for my system here. And if I say wanted to take this disk here and I wanted to encrypt it, all I have to do is right-click on the mouse, and I've got the ability here to start the encryption process. Of course, it will take some time for it to encrypt all the data, to set all of your passwords in place, etc. But you can set it all up through this interface built in to the operating system. So you can do this for any drive on your system, including flash drives and removable drives. Of course, you have to remember what your password is, or you could have a heck of a time getting your data unencrypted. I hope that answers your question. Wendy, thanks so much for asking. And finally, a note from Mr. Ray, who shouts, hey, Steve, loved your videos on Google Drive. I have a dilemma. How can I move photos from my Google Photos cloud to my external Seagate hard drive? I can't find anything on this. Keep up the great work. Hashtag Team Steve. Yes. I haven't been able to find a great solution for this either. There doesn't seem to be any automatic way of downloading all of your photos or at a time. However, I have discovered that if you move your mouse over top of any one photo, you can get a checkbox which allows you to multi-select multiple photos. So you can go through and you can select all the photos in a group and then use this download icon, this download tool that we have here in the upper right-hand corner, to download your photos. Having said that, there is another way to download collections of photos or albums. I'm going to take you deep inside the life of Steve. Last year I did a musical. This is my photo my Google Photos is a fairly new collection, but here's a collection of photos that I have from me performing, and a funny thing happened on the way to the forum last year. So there's Steve singing and dancing his way to stardom. Look at this. I'm looking at his feet. I don't know what foot to move next. Thank goodness Ray knows what he's doing. All right. If you've got a whole collection of photos like this, you can also download the entire collection here just by clicking here to download, and that will allow you to download the entire collection of photos as well. But so far, I haven't found a automatic syncing service that will allow you to take all of your Google Photos and back them up onto a hard drive. It's a bit of a manual process, a bit of a kludge at this point. If anybody has a better way of doing it, please comment below and share with us and let us know the better way of doing things. And that is all the time that we have for our second installment of Ask Dotto Tech. I wanted to point out once again that Ask Dotto Tech is brought to you through the generous support of our patrons at Patreon. If you want to find out what it's all about supporting the Dotto Tech site and what perks are included, I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page. And also remember, please subscribe to this channel and subscribe to our newsletter so you can hear about all of our upcoming live webinars and events. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.